Ensuring a square cut. Measure the hose OD with a diameter tape. Our example hose has an OD of 40/64, or 0.625. The guideline for brass ferrule selection is for the ferrule ID to be between 10 thousandths and 31 thousandths of an inch larger than the hose OD. From the brass ferrule page of the current Dixon catalog, select the proper ferrule and die. For our example hose, using our guideline, the correct ferrule would be the BFM 656 for medium weight hose or BFL 650 for lightweight hose. The die would be either R34 ribbed or P35 plain. Use of ribbed or plain dies is a matter of appearance preference. Begin by removing the wing nuts and cover plate. The setup of the 5111A and 1765A is essentially the same. The 1765A is pneumatically operated and has a fitting stop for mass production. The 5111A is manually operated without a fitting stop. The 1765A is featured here. Insert the die segments into the die holders with the numbers facing out. Replace the cover plate and install the wing nuts. Be careful not to over-tighten the wing nuts. If they're too tight, the die holders may bind and interfere with the operation of the machine, especially the 5111A. For the 1765A, disconnect the airline. Slide the hose with the stem and ferrule through the die opening. Position the ferrule for proper crimp location. For BFM and BFW style ferrules, position the ferrule so that there's equal amount of ferrule showing past both sides of the dies. BF850, BFMW1050, and BFL style ferrules require the fitting hex to just clear the dies. For 1765A, position the stop to contact the end of the fitting and tighten the thumb screw. Reconnect the air supply. Insert the hose with fitting and ferrule to its proper crimp location. Crimp the ferrule.
Dixon, the right connection.